Now we will discuss about link state routing. That is a part of our network layer discussion, where three main fundamental work principles of behind routing algorithm we stated. That is, first one is shortest path algorithm, second one is distance vector routing, and the third one is link state routing. So now today we will see link state routing. As all of we know that as a objective here, we will be discussing about what exactly link state routing all about, and to illustrate what are the steps to be taken under this particular algorithm and how it works, that is working. So these are our main two objectives. Now, as we know that there are primary problems caused distance vector routing demise, that is mainly the delay metric was queue length. It did not take line bandwidth into account when choosing routes. That is one thing. And the second is the algorithm often took too long to converge. That is nothing but the problem which we mentioned. That is the count to infinity problem. In the due discussion of distance vector routing, already we have illustrated that problem and how this entire process or the estimations carried out in distance vector routing after a number of exchanges are going to create this particular problem, that is the bad news propagates slowly and one cannot get the actual status of the router, and unnecessarily though it is down, still others will assume that as if there is a alternative path, and because of that kind of a conflict will get created and it will not remain measurable. So that's why it is referred as a count to infinity problem. Now we will today talk about the link state routing, where to certain extent this problem is resolved. Nowadays all these three protocols like OSPF, RIP and BGP are used in number of applications. Like RIP, we mentioned that they've used distance vector routing, and to overcome some limitations of RIP, when OSPF was introduced, then at that time definitely the link state routing was taken as a backbone working principle and algorithm. Distance vector routing was used in ARPANET until 1979, and afterwards it was replaced by link state routing. Then in case of link state routing, since we are going to follow some of the steps, but before going through them, we will little bit comment on what exactly it is. So delay metric was main feature in distance vector routing, and initially the lines were of 56 kbps something in 70s and 80s. So line bandwidth was not an issue, but after some line had been upgraded to 230 kbps and others to 1.54 mbps, there is bandwidth became a major problem, and it would not have been possible to change the delay metric to factor in line bandwidth. So such bandwidth switching was the issue, and with distance vector routing it was not possible to do. The distance vector routing often took too long to converge, even with tricks like split horizon, and therefore it was replaced by link state routing. The idea behind link state routing is simple, and we can simply split it in five parts. Like these are the steps or the say processes which we are going to follow. So first process is discover its neighbor, learn their network address, that is the discovery phase. Then second one is measurement phase, where we are going to measure the delay or cost to each of its neighbors. Then third one is construct a packet telling all it has just learned. Then fourth one is send this packet to all other routers, and fifth one is compute the shortest path to every other router. Here again shortest path algorithm is used. One by one we will see. So first thing is learning about neighbors. As the figure shows, even the sample network, how the nodes are connected, and the graph model of that, 9 routers and a simple LAN type of a connectivity. Here when the router is booted, its first task is to learn who is its neighbor. Every router is going to follow that. It accomplishes this properly by sending a special hello packet on each point-to-point line. The router on the other hand is expected to send back a reply telling who it is, and these names must be globally unique. So that is, its identification must be unique one, and so that it will understand. Now here a small arrangement wise kind of a representation wise change in the form of graph model, you can see how the router arrangement is done. Then second phase is we want to measure the line cost. So the linked routing algorithm requires each router to know for at least or it should have at least a reasonable knowledge about the estimation of the delay to each of its neighbors. So each one, how far it wants to know. And the most direct way to determine this delay is to send a special echo packet, simple thing, and over the line that the other side is required to send back immediately. By measuring the round trip time and dividing it by 2, the sending router can get a reasonable estimate of the delay. For even better results, the test can be conducted several times and the average is used. Now this is a kind of a estimation once done, delay measurement. Then say for example some traffic management is to be done. In linked routing, that care is also taken. There should be an even distribution of the traffic. Like sometimes say for this west east side, a kind of a subnet is shown here, then two lines are there, they are connecting these two networks like CF and EI. Now by chance suppose CF line gets crowded or a very huge traffic, high traffic is going to be there, then because of this measuring line cost step which is carried out, the traffic is transferred to the alternative path, that is EI. How and why this will be done? Because as a part it is going to send echo packet, and the router when comes to know that say in the beginning it has received that packet in few milliseconds or whatever that timeout delta delay, and now it is taking much more than that time, so it will understand that there is some problem related to traffic, so it should switch to alternative path. So that is the main thing under the sample network. With this for router B, we are like writing the distribution of the link state packets. Now once router has accumulated a full set of link state packets, it can construct the entire subnet graph, because every link is represented here. Every link is in fact represented twice, once for each direction, that is send and acknowledge.